Actually, first, I gotta give credit to Chanley and the folks at Court TV that have been in North Dakota for weeks. Gotta give credit to them. They're giving us the insight to the jurors. We can't see that as we're watching from the comfort of our homes and offices. But, I thought the surveillance was very powerful. And ultimately, the defense was really put in a position where either Chad Isaak is the unluckiest person in the world, right? Caught on surveillance, there's blood and fibers in his vehicle, in his home. You have shell casings, the exact number of rounds that were shot. You have the footprint. You have the exact same hoodie, the mask, gun parts that match the gun, or the evidence was planted. So really, to kind of point the finger at the boogeyman and everyone else that the defense tried to do, although it was somewhat effective, ultimately it was not enough to really overcome this avalanche of evidence, including the surveillance. So I think that's why after the jury sifted through the hundreds and hundreds of exhibits and videos yesterday and this morning, they were able to come to a verdict relatively quickly.
Right.